from O'Brien Field in Peoria, Illinois. It's the Class 2A baseball title game matching the Teutopolis Wooden Shoes and the Walther Lutheran Broncos. Hi again, everybody, and welcome to downtown Peoria. The entire baseball season in Class 2A baseball has come down to this. Teutopolis, your defending state champs, come into this ball game with a 32-2 record. On the other side, Walther Lutheran, what a tournament run they have had. They are 18-14, which means they started this tournament with a 12-14 record, yet one of these two teams will be bringing home that big hardware.
Well, what you have is arguably the defending state champions, the best team in the state of Illinois in 2-0 and 2A, that Teutopolis, and then arguably the hottest team in 2A. Even though Teutopolis has that great record, Walther Lutheran has just been incredible down the stretch, including that 17-hit onslaught yesterday, an impressive offensive juggernaut. We should have a good one here tonight.
Walther Lutheran, that 15-2 win over DuCoin in five innings. Teutopolis followed that up with a 6-4 win over Prophetstown. The coin flip has gone the way of Walther Lutheran. That means Teutopolis will bat first. Derek Thompson will do the pitching. He'll lead things off for the Wooden Shoes. Derek Repking, the catcher, bats second. Bo Blevernick is over at first base. He hits third. The cleanup hitter, the third baseman, Garrett Overbeck. Mark Niebrugge doing the DHing today. He's hitting for the right fielder, Dylan Niebrugge. Batting sixth, it'll be the shortstop, Dylan Hardick. Brock Swingler is in left field, batting seventh. Jordan Repke at second base. He is in the eighth spot. And batting ninth, the center fielder, Damon Haney. For the Broncos, from Walther Lutheran defensively, they'll have Lomnicki's in left and right field. It's Joe Lomnicki in left, John Lomnicki in right. Dan Ladolci, the pitcher last night, he is in center field. The third baseman is Luke Barajas. Chris Stevens, the shortstop. Second baseman, Anthony Garland, over at first. It's Chris Miller. Behind the plate, Josh Galvin, and getting the ball for your 2A championship game will be Jack Cockrell.
Cockrell, 2-2 with a 3.15 earned run average on the season. Only 20 innings pitched, but he finds himself starting the state title game. 17 strikeouts, three base on balls. Walther Lutheran's Broncos going to meet one more time at the pitcher's mound. You see the powwow, the fist going up as we get ready for the 2A state championship. And to call one of many of the state championship events he's called, here's the Hall of Fame voice of the Illinois High School Association, Dave Bernhard.
Thank you very much, Mark. It is overcast skies here in Peoria. It is a hot and muggy evening. It's been that way all weekend long. And we get things started here with one of the top players in the state. He plays for Teutopolis. He'll be doing the pitching in the bottom half of this inning, but he leads things off. It's Derek Thompson.
One of the top players in Illinois. Baseball Prep Report ranks him number 4. He might be drafted early next week. He was 0-for-5. That makes him that much more dangerous than yesterday's semifinal win.
McGrell brings that first one for a strike.
All the state championships you've been around, and every one of them has its own air of excitement, doesn't it?
Boy, it certainly does. And this one unique in that you have the defending state champs against a team you thought had no chance to get here when the tournament started. Garland at second base, who had a big game last night defensively, starts this one out with a 4-3 put out.
Ranges to his left. You could almost see Garland's confidence pick up as the weekend has gone along. He made every play early on yesterday, and then as the game progressed, so did his ability to get balls from to his right and to his left.
Derek Repking, he had a big triple last night. He's going first pitch hunting, and he'll send it out to center field. Ladolci will back it up a little bit, makes that one-handed grab, and that's a quick two outs here in the top of the first.
Well, we talked about Walther Lutheran. You said they were 14-18 at one point, what have you, losing, and they had a long losing streak along the way. But what Walther Lutheran has done is they've gotten healthy. They had a myriad of injuries early on in the season, put their team together. Once their team is together, their confidence has just risen.
Bo Blevernick, number 3 hitter in this powerful Teutopolis lineup, a team that hits 389. Steps in Blevernick, 479 average for himself. He had 3 hits and 4 at-bats last night and drove in a run.
Walther 18-14, so under 500 when this tournament started, before they were able to put everything together. Wins over Timothy, Immaculate Conception, Westminster, Aurora Christian, and Hersher, all 3 of those heavy underdogs as they advanced.
They had to go 9 innings to beat Immaculate Conception. Defeated defending Class 1A champs in Westminster Christian. And then the super sectional, they came behind for the 4th straight playoff game, trailed 8-2 to Hersher for scoring 7 runs in the 5th and 6th innings to pull out that 9-8 win. They are certainly the Cinderella story here in Class 2A.
Lutheran High School, Melrose Park, Illinois. Enrollment of 412. Principal is Jim Craven. Todd Fisher, Naperville North grad, athletic director.
It's a two-out walk. You believe in it? Bring up Garrett Overbeck. What a season this young man has had. One for three last night with a run scored in an RBI, but Overbeck on the season coming into this tournament, a 451 average with 50 runs batted in. Cockrell delivers. This ball's hit hard to right field. Driving the right fielder back, John Lemnicki, and he will make the running one-handed catch along the line. What a great play by John Lemnicki to close out the bottom of this first inning.
Nice defense in the outfield. Adolce earlier on, Lemnicki here, as that ball slicing away. Look at how far he has to run. He knows he's running out of real estate, but makes a solid catch to save a would-be run with two outs.
So we'll go to the bottom of the first inning. Walther Lutheran, see if they can keep their sticks as hot as they were last night. No score in your 2A championship. A 17-hit attack last night for Walther Lutheran. This is their lineup tonight in the 2A championship game. Joe Lomnicki, the left fielder, to lead things off. Dan Ladolci, the center fielder, bats second. Chris Stevens, wait to get a load of this guy. The shortstop hits third. Josh Galvin, the catcher, the cleanup spot. The pitcher, Shaq Cockrell, will bat fifth. John Lomnicki, the right fielder, just made that catch. Hits sixth. Luke Barajas, third baseman, bats seventh. In the eighth spot will be Sam Cattell, the designated hitter for Chris Miller. Anthony Garland will bat ninth and play second base. Brock Swingler, Damon Haney, and Dylan Niebrugge left to right in the Teutopolis outfield. The infield of Garrett Overbeck, Dylan Hardick, Jordan Repke, and Bo Blevernick from third to first. Derek Repke behind the plate. We talked about him before. Derek Thompson, the lefty, on the mound.
After this first pitch, we'll take a look at the superlative numbers of Derek Thompson.
Joe Lomnicki at the plate. Takes the ball down.
Thompson, a 0.13 earned run average, 9-0 on the season, 52 innings pitched. He's only given up 15 hits in that time.
That's a fair ball. Rifled across is Garrett Overbeck.
One more addendum to the Derek Thompson line. He did indeed have a save yesterday in the semifinal. 1 1/3 innings, 3 strikeouts, and a number to watch, 21 pitches. He probably looks at that just as a bullpen session, if you will. He looks pretty strong in the early going.
Dan Ladolci will take the ball down. Ladolci 3-for-4. Joe Lomnicki 2-for-4 yesterday. The next batter, Chris Stevens, 3-for-3. Josh Galvin 3-for-3. Those were the numbers put up by the first four batters in this Walther Lutheran order. They had 11 hits in 14 at-bats. And they scored 9 of the runs tallied by Walther Lutheran. That's a foul ball.
Great comment by first-year head coach Matt Twomey when he was asked in the postgame why the offensive juggernaut. And he said, one, we have really good hitters, and two, it's the first time in 3 games we haven't been facing somebody throwing 90-plus. Some awesome pitching he saw from Westminster Christian, Aurora Christian, and Hersher.
Well, in fact, against Westminster Christian, combination of Elder and Perez struck out the first 15 outs of Walther Lutheran, and yet the Broncos come and win that game.
Yeah, that's unheard of. The defending state champion, Westminster Christian.
One ball and two strikes. Dan Ladolci. And it goes to 2-2.
Derek Thompson will get up there somewhere between 85, 88 miles an hour.
He was a winning pitcher in last year's state championship game, a 5-1 win over Harrisburg. Off the fist, Dylan Hardick will have to hurry. Gets him by half a step.
Very solid play with a solid arm by Dylan Hardick. He knew and trusted his own arm, saw it off at the hands of Ladolce. I watched him get around the ball, square it off, and trust his arm, which he did.
Nice big target over at first base in the form of Bo Blevernick. And with two outs, that brings us to Chris Stevens. Stevens, so he said, 3-for-3 yesterday. He scored 4 runs in the season. Stevens, a 5-10 hitter.
Now, I think you're talking right now the pitcher on the hill, Thompson, one of the best senior prospects in Illinois. The junior Stevens will be one of the top seniors in Illinois next year, not a doubt in my mind. He has a chance to be followed by numerous professional scouts, both this pitcher and this batter in this challenge match going on.
Stevens, 6'3", 200-pound junior. As you look at Derek Thompson.
Stevens scored 4 runs yesterday, 3 extra base hits.
Here's the 0-2 pitch. That's a hard fastball just missing inside.
Great location.
You talk about location. The walk totals for Derek Thompson are unreal over the course of the season. Does he get him to go on the outside? Only five walks this year.
That's unheard of. Straight change there. So he goes fastball on his hands. And then with placement, movement, placement, velocity, he moves the ball to the outer part.
Stevens puts this one in the air. Haney has to get Brown. Haney on the move. This ball is going to get to the wall in center field. Chris Stevens, round second, headed to third. The throw, not in time. A two-out triple by Chris Stevens.
Quality at bat by Chris Stevens, who continues to impress. Look at how quick his hands are. Boom, gets his hips right through that ball. He hits it a long way against Derek Thompson. Now he found himself in the hole, 0-2. Took a borderline pitch on the inside, took a borderline pitch on the outside, got a fastball he could work with and drove it over the head of Damon Haney in center field to the furthest part of the ballpark.
And that will bring up Josh Galvin, this young man you're looking at, the catcher, six runs batted in yesterday in a 3-for-3 performance.
That's a week long or 2 weeks long performance for many athletes.
Galvin on the season, 371 batting average. Now has 43 runs batted in. On one hop to the shortstop, Hardick. And that will retire the side. So the two-out triple by Stevens. He is stranded at third. One inning gone here in your 2A championship game. No score. Teutopolis and Walther Lutheran here on IHSA.TV. Earlier in the week, those umbrellas were used to shade people from the hard sun that we've had here. Well, just a little while ago during the break, we had a little light rain shower. I think it's let up right now, but people have come prepared to Peoria. They've come from Melrose Park in the Chicago area. They have come from T-Town in Teutopolis. And we go to the top of the second inning. It'll be Mark Niebrugge, Dylan Hardick, and Brock Swingler for the Wooden Shoes from T-Town, your defending Class 2A state champions.
Niebrugge works for the open stance. You see his front foot almost out of the batter's box, but then he closes it down and steps his front side in as the pitch arrives.
Niebrugge had a couple of hits yesterday and two RBIs in that 6-4 win over Erie Prophetstown. Sends this one out to Stevens at short, scoops it up. Across he goes, one out.
Well done. Niebrugge hit that ball somewhat on the nose, but smooth and silky smooth. Watch Stevens gather this ball and stay right over the top. Very, very soft hands over the top. First out of the inning, ever so important.
Dylan Hardick, the shortstop, steps into the batter's box for Teutopolis. Shaq Cuckerell. Deliver outside.
Cuckerell, another kind of a story here. Only 20 innings pitched on the season. 3.15 earned run average.
Hit hard to left field. Hardick will have himself a base hit. Scampers down that first baseline, makes a good turn at first. And he'll come right on back. One out single for Dylan Hardick.
Finish my thought on Cockrell as almost on cue. He gives up the base hit. I was just going to say, I think that they'll move the baseball against him. He's not overpowering, but I also don't think he'll beat himself. He'll be around the plate and allow his defense to make plays. That's what we'll come down to.
Brock Swingler at the plate now for Teutopolis as the rain resumes. High into the air, right field. They're going to have to be looking straight up in the raindrops in this one. Garland gives way to the right fielder, John Lomnicki, for the second out. Good communication there. Your infielder goes out as long and as hard as he can until your outfielder calls him off. And we've seen Lomnicki handle that right field spot very nicely here in the first two innings.
You can see on your screen the rain picking up. But we can report from here as we see the vast horizon. The clouds, although darkening, it's not a severe storm moving in, anything like that. I think you're going to see some just steady overcast here for quite a while.
Jordan Repke at the plate for Teutopolis. Repke had a hit and three at bats. 13 hits last night for Teutopolis. Took him a while to get going. Once they did, they stacked him up. They trailed Erie Prophetstown 2-0 at the end of three innings, but then scored two in the fourth, one in the fifth, three in the sixth. And we're leading 6-2 until Prophetstown got a couple in the bottom of the sixth. This ball's hitting the right center. Who's going to get this one? It'll be the center fielder, Dan Ladolce. Good outfield play here early by Walther Lutheran. So the two out or the one out single by Hardick does not harm Walther Lutheran. We'll go to the bottom of the second inning. This game moving right along. Sharply played, no score. Your IHSA quiz tonight is, what are those Walther Lutheran fans spelling? We'll get back to that in just a second as Shaq Cockrell will lead things off with the foul ball. We saw, what, a G, an O? Of course, it looks like some of it has been smeared with the rain. There it is again.
Paint.
Okay.
Oh, there's S. Yeah, but is it G? Or does he not know how to spell?
Okay, it's Walther Lutheran Broncos. Maybe it's the name of a player. Okay, that's your IHSA quiz.
So earlier we saw some students that had spelled out their team mascot's name.
Was Panthers.
Yep. The Panthers, and we said those were graduates. Maybe that young man's still a freshman. I don't know.
Cockrell last night hitting two at bat, scored twice. Again, it was a 17-hit attack for Walther Lutheran.
30 hits between these two teams last night in each of their respective semifinal victories, 17 and 13 respectively.
Cockrell down in the count, no balls and two strikes. Thompson just misses in the outside corner. Boy, he has such a great touch with that ball. Five walks tells you one thing. The other tells you that he knows exactly where that ball is going at all times.
Command, location, command of everything he does on the hill.
To the third baseman, Overbeck. Up, over, not in time.
Wow, that was a bang banger. And getting down the line, Cockrell gets the call. Moves pretty well for a big man, doesn't he?
Overbeck did all he could. And let's see if they get a runner, a courtesy runner for the pitcher. They will. This looks like it may be Mike Trotty out there to run for Cockrell. An infield hit for Cockrell. Here comes Trotty. And at the plate is Joe Lomnicki.
Lomnicki, pretty good tournament in his own right and playing a pretty solid right field.
Lomnicki puts the bunt down. It's a good one. Repking, the catcher, jumps out in a hurry. Everybody did their job. The runner advances with one out.
And that just shows you the respect that Matt Twomey has for Derek Thompson. You got a team that's 17 hits yesterday, but he knows he can't string them together against Thompson. Plays small ball. Well executed bunt by John Lomnicki. Walther Lutheran with a man in scoring position.
We'll bring up Luke Barajas playing third base tonight with Cockrell on the mound. Barajas was a pinch hitter yesterday, walked with the bases loaded. It's credit for an RBI.
375 hitter on the season.
Inside 2-0.
So Walther has seen some pretty good presence on the hill throughout this tournament, the last three, four, five games now, maybe this being the best.
Well, and you can tell by the way they're going up there with an approach. They are not intimidated by Derek Thompson. Lights are on here at O'Brien Field. We're in the bottom of the second inning. No score. Runner out at second with one out. And that's a called strike.
Assistant coach Leonard Stevens coaching in the first base box. He is incredibly animated down there, just imploring Barajas to be aggressive at the plate.
Strikeout Thompson, that's strikeout number one for the lefty. Two outs in the inning. We go to Sam Cattell. Derek Thompson signed with John A. Logan College. But I think he's going to be staying close to his telephone in the upcoming week. Major League draft is held. To the right side, nice little backhand by Bliebernick. He'll do it himself. Both teams playing some good defense here early. Two innings in the book in your Class 2A championship game from Peoria. We have no score. Teutopolis bidding to go back-to-back against Walther Lutheran. Back with the third inning right after this. Teutopolis fans will be a little bit damp from the brief shower we had. Looking to go back to back on the other side. Walther Lutheran. Okay, now you get a better look. Let's go. Jeez. We're going to get it before we leave, right? Okay. First pitch. Damon Haney hits this one to center field right at Ladolci, and that's one out. I like the aggression that both of these teams are showing at the plate. Some would say, you know, let's get a good look at these people, but these are two offensive teams. You know, keep that in mind. I mean, you don't change your game plan here in the championship game. Back to the top of the order we go, and Derek Thompson. He grounded out 0 for 6 in the tournament, hitting from the leadoff spot.
T-Town with the defending state champions, as you mentioned, trying to go back-to-back, beat Harrisburg last year 5-1. State finals, Silver Cross Field, Joliet, the venue of next week's 3 and 4A state finals.
You're good. We'll be there for that one. That will begin at 10 o'clock on Friday morning right here on IHSA.tv with 3A baseball. Well, there have been 7 outs in the game by Teutopolis. 5 of them have been flyouts to the outfield. Do you make anything of that? You had mentioned it that Cockrell will, the ball will be put in play against him, but what about the idea of the fly ball ground ball ratio?
Well, because I think he's getting the ball up a little bit and they're getting some elevation, but you mentioned at the close, what a fine outfield that we've seen exhibited by Walther Lutheran defensively throughout this tournament.
Chopper to first. Ooh, that stayed down for Miller. And out at first is Thompson as Cockrell comes over to cover. Wow, recovery by the first baseman Miller, and Cockrell never slowed up. He came hard from the mound all the way.
I tell you what, great job just blocking that ball by Miller, and then he finds the handle, and his pitcher does a great job, Cockrell, getting there. Again, instead of anticipating, oh, easy play, I don't need to get over there, he anticipated the fact that he has to field his position, and what a well-executed play by Walther Lutheran's first baseman pitcher combination.
That's 2 quick outs here in the top of the third inning. At the plate now is Derek Repking. One of the weaknesses at times this year for the Broncos from Walther Lutheran is the defense has made errors, and they have helped their opponents out at times. However, here in the state tournament, it's been a whole new season for Walther Lutheran.
If you'd start getting radar guns out, Cockrell probably, Dave, high 70s, very low 80s. But you know what? He's around the plate, and mixes in a breaking ball here or there, hits an edge here and there, and his defense has made plays tonight through 2 2/3 innings.
You know, you watch him, and he's a third baseman, but he doesn't have any wasted motion. It's almost like you're teaching a fielder, here's all you have to do, just kick and throw. That's a walk, though, to Repking with 2 outs. My point being, you know, sometimes pitchers, you know, worry about their sidestep, their hands over their head, their hands at the belt. It just looks like the simplest motion for this young man is just get it, step forward, and let it go.
Nice physique, nice build on the pitcher Cockrell. 6'3", 200, strong.
6'4", first baseman Bo Blevernick at the plate for Teutopolis. With 2 outs, let's see if Repking might be on the move.
And let's see how well Cockrell does indeed get the ball up to the plate for his catcher Galvin to have a chance.
Pickoff throw behind the runner. Miller takes that throw in front of the bag.
Had the stopwatch on. That pitch from the time he lifted his front foot to the time it hit catcher Josh Galvin's hand or glove was 1.21. Anything under 1.4 is more than acceptable.
Swing and a miss, a 3-pitch strikeout for Cockrell. So for the third straight inning, Teutopolis will leave one runner aboard. We have played 2.5. We have no score. Shaq Cockrell in the state championship game with a nice little 12-6 curveball gets Blevernick. We'll go to the bottom of the third. Walther Lutheran coming to the plate looking for a run. There's the Walther Lutheran dugout, and according to head coach Matt Twomey, a very loose bunch of guys. They like to have fun. They wear their emotions on their sleeves. They've parlayed it here to an appearance in a state title game.
Now, for those fans that don't know Walther Lutheran's dimension at their home field, it's 256 feet to right field. So when you're somebody like Anthony Garland, you step up and you see 400 to center and 360 to right, it doesn't look like home at all.
Garland, the number 9 hitter here in the Broncos order, facing Derek Thompson. Each team has put one runner on base in each of these first 5 half innings of play. Big cut from Garland.
Gas, just good old-fashioned hard ball right there. He says, here it is, catch me if you can. Threw that ball right by Garland.
ball and two strikes. Thompson peers over that glove. Two balls, two strikes. Very overcast here in Peoria, but really no threat of rain, if there is any. It's just with something that would just spring up immediately, but there is no threat here to impact this game, at least according to the latest radar.
I think a very wise decision by the Illinois High School Association. Neither team took infield. They really tried to expedite the process between games, a six-inning game for third place, knowing that with these weather conditions, the barometric pressure, fronts moving here and there, temperature change, a shower could pop up anytime.
2-2 pitch. Garland is able to get his bat on the ball, and who wants this one? Believer Nick, the first base, will make the grab on the outfield grass. You said neither team took infield. We've had some really solid and then some great defensive plays here early. So much for having to take that 10 minutes to get yourself loosened up on the field.
Well, you and I talked about that between games. We found out that that was going to be the decision. Both teams have been on the field. Both teams well rested. Both teams, besides being well rested today, I mean, the last game of the evening, both teams were very, very active the last week or so. So enough is enough. I think both coaches and players, hey, let's just get it on.
To the top of the order, and Joe Lomnicki bounced out to third his first time up. Count evens at a ball and a strike.
Lomnicki, LaDolce, and Lomnicki in the outfield cover an awful lot of ground when they're out there defensively.
Chopped to the left side. Nice job over back to cut it off. Twice, Lomnicki has gone 5-3. Two outs to LaDolce.
Garrett Overbeck showing some range going to his left. Steps into the pitch. A good defender will have pre-pitch movement to square up and get some momentum into the pitch toward the batter and then react as soon as bat meets ball.
LaDolce with extra base power, I think, from the number two spot. The wind is blowing out to right. It's been pretty steady all day. Today it's kind of blown from the left field foul pole to the right field foul pole, but it, in general, out to right field, probably about 10 miles per hour right now. Temperature's dropped to 83 degrees, by the way.
LaDolce in the batter's box yesterday on the hill, improved to 7-0 with five innings pitched, gave up just one earned run, and very efficiently, only 58 pitches to get that win.
Good fastball right there on the inside part of the plate. Balls and a strike. Line drive center field, sinking and a base hit. So the streak continues where each team has put a runner on base in each half inning. And we have had a lightning flash and a thunder clash, and they will clear the field. And again, for those of you that are not familiar with National Federation rules, if there is lightning seen, that is an automatic 30-minute delay from the moment of lightning and from the moment of the last sighting of lightning. So again, I'll review again if you weren't with us in our third place game. We will be in a 30-minute delay minimum from right now. If sometime during these 30 minutes there is another sighting of lightning, that 30-minute clock will reset and it will continue on. The bottom line is we'll take a break. We are in the bottom of the third inning. There are two outs. Dan LaDolce will be at first base. When we're ready to resume play, make sure you're with us. So keep that computer turned on right there. There is the score. We have no score. A good one here in your 2A championship game from Peoria. Back when the weather breaks, coming up. Glad to have you back with us in Peoria. About a 44 minute rain delay, a lightning delay, a combination of both. We did have some rain. They put the tarp on the field, but we are ready to roll here in the bottom of the third inning. Along with the Hall of Fame coach, state championship coach Mark Lindo, I'm Dave Bernhardt, and here's your situation. Bottom of the third, no score here in your 2A championship game with two outs. Dan LaDolce single to center, and that's when we had the lightning. And that's where we will resume with Chris Stevens stepping into the batter's box.
And we might have to dodge some raindrops still before this one's all over. I didn't like your cell phone showing the radar that's got us surrounded with some yellow as well. But Chris Stevens steps to the plate, triple his first time up, so he's 4-for-4 in this tournament. And my first comment from this situation with two outs, you better play your defense deep. If you're Teutopolis, you know, no extra base hits here, so they can't score a run with two outs with a ball in the gap.
Well, there's a pretty big gap right now in left center field as the center fielder Damon Haney shading Stevens to right center. 45-minute delay officially after that first pitch. Derek Thompson on the mound. He's given up three hits here tonight. Each of the half innings has had one base runner for each of these teams. Stevenson waves at that one.
We mentioned it before the 45-minute delay. Both pitchers, Derek Thompson and Shaq Cockrell for Walther, incredible rhythm. They were getting it, throwing it, defense making plays. How will they both respond after a 45-minute stoppage of play?
You know, it's interesting. We had a 45-minute delay, and the first nearly three innings took only about 30 minutes. Dolce, the lead at first. He breaks. Stepping off is Thompson, and they've got Dolce. Still alive. Now they put the tag on him. So that was truly a first move, and it was a bit too early first move. Thompson just very calmly steps off, and that is how this inning comes to a close. So we will have played through three innings. We go to the fourth, still no score in your 2A championship game on IHSA.TV. Now will be Teutopolis' turn in the top of the fourth inning. 4, 5, and 6 in their order. Overbeck, Niebrugge, and Hardik.
Shaq Cockrell has given up just one hit in his first three innings of work. Not overpowering, but around the zone, changing speeds, moving batter's eyes inside, outside, up and down. Very effective start for basically a guy that's a part-time pitcher, only 2-2 on the season, 20 innings pitched.
He's given up one hit, walked two, and struck out one. Overbeck, a fly out his first time up. Grell gets it and throws it. Overbeck is a man who can take a zero off the board here in a hurry with one swing. That ball is ripped to the left field line. Cutting it off will be Joe Lomnicki. Gets there in a hurry and gets it back in a hurry. It's a long single for Overbeck to lead off the fourth.
He absolutely scalded that ball over the head of Luke Barajas into left field down the line. We've been giving superlative praise to the outfield, if you will, of Walther Lutheran defensively. Joe Lomnicki makes a great play, gets to it in a hurry, gets it in a hurry, and holds Overbeck to a single.
Mark Niebrugge to bunt, pops it up, and that is a foul ball. It was interesting. Our home plate umpire in this game, Kirk Hacker, pointed as if it was a fair ball. Take a look here.
So you see Niebrugge gets the barrel of the bat below the ball. That forced a pop-up. You want to stay above the ball. And then a smart play by the catcher, Galvin, to let it spin foul.
One strike on Niebrugge.
He's got to find a ball down that he can bunt and catch the ball with the bat.
Pick off back to first. And Miller, luckily for him, got a glove on the ball.
Good try, Josh.
If Miller's on the bag and that throw is good, they have Overbeck leaning. That's a couple of ifs, big ifs, of course. Ball and a strike. Oh, no, they're going to say it's two strikes.
0-2, B, 0-2, right there, good. Right there, B. Right there. All right, spin it in, Phil, spin it.
Justin Fleener is asking about that last pitch, whether he offered or whether it was a called strike, but it will be an 0-2 count.
So that changes the complexion of this at bat. Two schools of thought. Quite clearly, many people think you don't bunt with two strikes because a bunt foul is out, but many coaches think, if I want you to bunt, I'm going to make you bunt no matter how many strikes.
And he looked like he was ready to swing. The ball's outside, 1-2. Remember, this is a Teutopolis team that hits 389 as a team. They can hurt you in all parts of their order. Short lead for Overbeck at first. And now 2-2.
Interesting, we'll see a shot of Cockrell out of the stretch set position. Watch how closed he has his front side. Now that's good, except for now he's got to open up more because it cost him some time delivering to home plate.
And 0-2 count has become 3-2.
Justin Fleener not flashing any signs. I thought he might put his man in motion with 3-2.
That's exactly where I was looking as well. Overbeck stays, the pitch, just getting a piece of it.
See, and you have a person in Garrett Overbeck that is not fleet of foot. We know that. But you got to figure that Niebrugge's going to put bat on ball.
Come on, big daddy.
Now Fleener running through some short sequence of signs.
Give me two here.
So it's not that you think your base runner is going to steal a base. That's not what it would be. It's just that you do think if you send him that your hitter Niebrugge will make contact.
On the full count, Niebrugge to the left side. Luke Barajas cannot handle it. And that will be an error on Barajas, and Teutopolis has their first two men aboard here in the fourth.
That ball never came up. Barajas expected it to. He expected the ball to come up for him, and he just didn't get his glove down going to his left. He was going towards second base. That was tailor-made 5-4-3 without the runner going. But before you turn a double play, you gotta catch the baseball. It's a simple game.
Runners first and second, nobody out. Dylan Hardick at the plate. He singled to left his last time, but if the wooden shoes were bunting with the runner at first, nobody out, you've got to believe that Hardick may try to lay one down here. The third baseman Barajas playing way back, so Cockrell is in charge of that third baseline here.
Hardick's got a free base hit if he can bunt it on the grass to the left side.
No bunt there. Guessing game continues here. Hardick steps back in. He's a 289 hitter. No score, top of the fourth inning. 2A championship. Hardick hits this one hard to right center field. This will split the outfielders. Overbeck coming around right behind him is Niebrugge. Niebrugge will stop at third. Overbeck scores the first run of the game. Runners second and third. Nobody out in a 1-0 Teutopolis lead.
Well, they take advantage of the first error of the game by getting two runners safely on board. Then Hardick just mashes that ball into right center field. John Lomnicki just can't chase it down. Center fielder LaDolce can't chase it down. Lomnicki gets it in quickly, but not quickly enough. First run scores, and the table is now set for Swingler.
Hardick swinging away, no thought of a bunt, and obviously it pays big dividends. 7-8-9 coming up here in the order for Teutopolis, and a long conversation on the mound that you are seeing. The other one taking place between home plate and third base, and that's between Fleener and Swingler. The message here may be to Swingler, okay, let's work hard. Let's work hard to get that ball to the right side. Walther Lutheran will play their infield in tight. Last night, Teutopolis held scoreless through the first three innings before scoring. The T-Town fans enjoying what they're seeing. Swingler, high, short, and center fielder doesn't see it. LaDolce didn't see it. And Lomnicki will make the catch. The runner at third had come halfway down the line. That's Mark Niebrugge. He has to hustle himself back.
I'll tell you what a great play by Lomnicki staying with it, because that's the center field's ball. The infield's playing in, but we talked about the difficulty seeing. It is right between, in between and betwixt right now as far as the sight lines, because you have a gray sky, the lights haven't taken effect, and the center fielder saying the whole time, I don't see it, came out of nowhere into your picture. Lomnicki just saved definitely a run, maybe two at least for now.
Jordan Repke at the plate. The infield still in with one out.
Yeah, they're not out of jail yet, but they're one step closer.
Well, that's two great plays that Lomnicki has made in this game. He made a running catch deep in the right field corner in the first inning. And now this one here.
If somehow they get out of this jam, that could be a game-saving play.
Count now 2-0 to Repke. He flew out to center his last time. The outfield playing very shallow for Repke. Mark Niebrugge at third. Dylan Hardick at second. A run in here in the fourth. To the left side, Barajas looks the runner back to third. Throws to first, gets the out. Runners hold.
Well, they had one key out on a great play, a second key out as they enticed the ground ball by Ripke. Now they go to Damon Haney, and they are one more batter from getting out of a huge jam. Two on and nobody out at the second and third. And this is a huge, huge at-bat in this game. 1-0 or 3-0.
Damon Haney flew out to center. He's the number 9 hitter in the order. It's a little bit low. Don't be fooled by the spot in the order Haney hits from, however. He is a 352 hitter on the season.
2-for-3 yesterday in the state semifinal.
And this one is fair down the third baseline. One run scores. Here comes another. Damon Haney motoring to second base, and your number 9 hitter is just driven in two for a 3-0 Teutopolis lead.
On cue, you called it, Dave Bernhard. In the 9 hole, a lot of coaches like to put, you know, a solid hitter in that spot to turn the lineup back over, and they do just that. He gets the big key 2-out hit, picking up his prior teammates Swingler and Repke, who weren't able to get the runners in.
To the top of the order, and Derek Thompson looking for his first hit in the state finals.
0-for-7 the 2 days.
Hits this one a line drive to right field. Lomnicki comes on and makes another great catch.
Ron Swoboda, 1969 Mets, disowning right field. I just dated myself.
Big inning for the wooden shoes from Teutopolis. Despite this play to close out the inning by Lomnicki, Teutopolis picks up 3 runs. They do it by way of 3 hits, and we go to the bottom of the 4th. Walther Lutheran will break their huddle down by 3. 3 runs in the top half of the 4th inning for Teutopolis, thanks to single and RBI double by Dylan Hardick, a 2-run double by Damon Haney, throwing a fielding error, and it's 3-0 Teutopolis, with Chris Stevens at the plate to face Derek Thompson here in the bottom of number 4. Stevens hits this one hard. It hangs up enough, however, to get to the left fielder Swingler.
They finally got him out, the first time he has not reached safely in this state tournament. He got that one off the end of the bat, and playing him perfectly was the left fielder Singler.
Now Josh Galvin will come to the plate. Thompson breathes a cleansing breath there. Galvin bounced out his first time up. And the Broncos come up there swinging. This is nothing new for them. This is just the offensive philosophy they have. They free swingers, they'll not take a pitch due to the count or due necessarily to the game situation. They just get up there to hit.
Swingler made that catch on Stevens playing very deep. He's very deep right now against Josh Galvin.
Pitches inside. 1-1, 1-out. One thing that Matt Twomey, the head coach of Walther Lutheran, did not want to do is give the man on the mound, Derek Thompson, a lead to work with. He is a shutdown pitcher. He has a 3-run advantage right now.
0.13 earned run average. Minuscule, microscopic.
One and two to Galvin. Good cut. He's right on it. Josh Galvin, a 5'10", 185-pound junior. You have a feeling some college people are going to be out in Melrose Park keeping an eye on Walther Lutheran next year.
Yeah, he made a very good first impression on us yesterday with the bat, but also just his ability to handle his pitching staff.
Thompson gets him. Second strikeout of the night for Thompson.
Good sequence by Thompson, because as you mentioned, Galvin was right on the fastball. Then he just throws the hammer right down at his back foot. Off speed got him out in front, and he couldn't lay off it. A well-located pitch by the All-Stater.
Brings up Shaq Cockrell, the pitcher. Cockrell with an infield single his first time up. Big gap, huge gap in left center field. Left fielder Swingler playing very deep. The center fielder Damon Haney playing shallow and shaded into right center.
Okay, interesting positioning. I see the fact that Haney be playing over that way, expecting hitters to swing late.
This ball is ripped by Cockrell. That is a fair ball down into the corner. Swingler quickly with it. Cockrell on the move, and he has himself a two-out double.
What a big lift it would be for Walther Lutheran to score a run in this inning. They just gave up three in the top half. Breaking ball down, head of the bat goes down with it. He drills that ball to left field. But with you just gave up three in the top of the fourth. Two outs, bottom of the fourth, nothing going. If you could pick up a two-out run, that would just really, really lift your spirits and get you back to feeling good about yourself.
Hits are even at four. John Lomnicki at the plate. Look at Cockrell out at second base. He's another junior in this lineup. 3-4-5 hitters, all juniors for Walther Lutheran. Lomnicki to the shortstop, backhanded by Hardick. Accurate throw across, and that closes out the fourth inning. Cockrell is left stranded at second base, and it was a productive inning. The fourth inning for Teutopolis. The Wooden Shoes will head to their dugout. They're ready to hit again, and they'll hit with a 3-0 lead as we'll go to the top of the fifth inning as you're watching the 2A Boys Baseball Championships from Peoria on IHSA.TV. Justin Fleener, the 11th year head coach for Teutopolis, patrolling that third base coaching box. He won a state title last year. Third place finish in 2005, and prior to that, Teutopolis with a couple other state finishes, third in 2000-2005, a second place finish in 99 to go along with last year's state championship.
277 and 64 in 11 years, not too shabby. Assistant girls basketball coach, so keeps himself busy in the winter.
His leadoff man is Derek Repking here in the fifth.
His assistant to pitcher Derek Thompson's mother, who's the head women's coach for the Lady Shoes.
Successful year for Teutopolis in basketball.
What, new?
Yeah. Successful yet disappointing as both the boys and girls teams were eliminated in super sectional play. Repking tonight flew out to center and he's walked. Teutopolis last year, 5-1 winners in the championship game over Harrisburg. That rain delay turned the momentum of this game. I mean, you know, you don't say, well, that's the reason why Teutopolis got three in the top of the fourth inning, but gave them a chance, I think, to maybe collect their breath a little bit because Walther Lutheran had been playing very well through the first three.
What did we say? We played 2.5 innings in, 31 minutes, something like that. Mm-hmm. And we just had great pace and rhythm. Defenses were playing, you know, outstanding ball. And then one miscue opened up the floodgates in Walther Lutheran's error last inning.
Galvin will make the accurate throw. He does to Miller. One out here in the fifth. Second strikeout of the game for Cockrell.
Cockrell trusted his catcher there. He threw that breaking ball in the dirt, and that was intentional. When you have a good catcher like Josh Galvin, you want to throw the ball in the dirt, let him block it, and get hitters to chase things out of their comfort zone.
Oh, Blevernick, 0-for-1 tonight, a walk and a strikeout. 6'4" frame, stands well off the plate. Fouls this one out of play to the right side. We will be in Joliet next weekend. Starting Friday at 10 o'clock, it will be the semifinals in 3A. Semifinals 3A, 4A on Friday, then we'll repeat the whole third place championship action on Saturday right here on IHSA.TV. Of course, you can order DVDs of all of these games at prepfilms.com. Levernick to right field. John Lomnicki saw it all the way. Makes a grab for the second out.
Back in rhythm is pitcher Cockrell. But starting things off was Overbeck, and he's the guy that's up now to start off that big three-run inning with a solidly laced base hit down the left field line on a hanging breaking ball.
Cockrell dealing quickly. It's what we saw from both these two pitchers. You know, you talk about the pace of the game. Both pitchers just wanted to get it and throw it. All the hitters were up there swinging away, getting things started. And when that happens, when both of those things happen, then your defenses do become sharper.
It was a superior level of high school baseball that went on for like 30 minutes. And not that it's lost much of a beat with that three-run inning, but it was really a fun pace to be involved in before the delay.
1-0 pitch, back and out of play.
Hey, Shaq, yeah, that's a good pitch, baby.
Teutopolis fans,
that's a good pitch right
a little
there,
thinner yesterday than today. I think they were saving their gas money for the state championship game here in Peoria.
And Walther fans going to have a short night because they have graduation tomorrow. Finishing the state title tonight. Got to get home, put the caps and gowns on.
One ball and two strikes to Overbeck. Pecorell looking to close out this inning. The bouncer to Stevens at short. Gets Overbeck by a step. So a 1-2-3 inning for Cockrell in the top of the fifth. We'll head to the bottom of number five. It's a 3-0 lead for Teutopolis here in your 2A championship game as the Wooden Shoes look to go back-to-back. Peeking into that third base dugout for Walther Lutheran. Time for their bats to make some noise. They have four hits tonight against Derek Thompson, but they're down by three, and it will be 7-8-9 in their order. Barajas, Catal, and Garland.
Definitely starting to feel a sense of urgency. Baseball, a game of outs. They're down to their last nine. And with the slants of Derek Thompson, you have to take advantage of every opportunity you get. The Broncos on the evening, 0-for-4 with runners in scoring position tonight.
Two balls and no strikes to Barajas. Has to figure he's going to get a good one here. He went up there hacking.
And you called it on 2-0. He figured to get a good one. He did not have a good pass to the baseball there. Took a ball on the outer edge and tried to turn his hands over and pull it. Cardinal sin of hitting.
Fastball right by him.
Rogers struck out the first time, and you watch his swing. He's got to be much shorter of the ball. He cannot swing with this long and not strike out against this pitcher.
Sends that one straight back into the screen behind home plate.
So a fan say, well, what's a long swing? He's got to keep his hands in closer to his body, which allows the bat to get through the zone quicker. When you're long to the ball, get your hands out, he'll never catch up to this 86-mile-an-hour fastball.
Three balls and two strikes. Thompson didn't like that one. Didn't feel good. It came out of his hand in a manner he's not accustomed to.
Five walks on the season. You wouldn't expect him to throw ball four.
Strikeout number three. One out to Catal.
He got him out to extend his zone. Ball up over his hands. And a little bit of fist pump, if you will, by Derek Thompson, kind of feeling it right now, adrenaline-wise.
You know, in a certain extent, as Catal is up there, Thompson reminds me of a lefty on the south side of Chicago, Matt Thornton, in terms of the nice, smooth delivery, and all of a sudden that ball gets on you in a hurry. Obviously, he doesn't have the velocity of a major league pitcher, but in a relative sense, that ball just seems to jump out of his hand.
Yeah, it explodes to home plate.
Count 0-2 now to Sam Catal, who had bounced out to the first baseman his first time up. I have a feeling Mr. Derek Thompson's starting to feel it a little bit right now here in the bottom of the fifth inning.
Well, how much more effective is every pitcher, but especially a fastball pitcher like that, when you're up on the count 0-2, 0-2, because you expand the strike zone of a hitter. He's telling his defense, watch Anthony Garland's ability to bunt. So on cue, Garrett Overbeck moves up at the third base position, taking away that would-be bunt.
Number nine hitter in the Walther Lutheran lineup, Anthony Garland. 292 average coming in.
Now, how neat is it when, you know, these guys know each other so well that they can talk to each other and position each other? And we talked about it yesterday in their semifinal game. Over 90 games they have played since last year's championship game against Harrisburg, counting their fall league last summer and then this spring.
Three balls and no strikes to Garland. If you walk only five batters in a season, you don't get many three-ball counts either. Batting practice fastball. Or at least in Thompson's case, batting practice, that'd be pretty good pop for anybody else. Three balls and a strike. and two. Those will be the two best pitches that Anthony Garland will see in this at bat. Let's see whether what Thompson comes with here.
And the zone's expanded once again. You might even get him to chase something bad.
And that's a walk. And that's a story. Only his sixth walk of the season. We'll go with over 100 strikeouts.
Six walks in 53, 54, 55, 56, 57 innings pitched now. He's only allowed six free passes.
Garland at first for the leadoff man in the Broncos order. That's Joe Lomnicki. Down by three. You don't figure to see Garland do anything fancy over at first. Light starting to have a little bit more of an impact here at O'Brien Field. Pitch to Lomnicki. One ball, one strike.
Lomnicki's had a good approach. He's gone the opposite way against him twice. 2-5-3 putouts.
That's two pitches now. We've got three pitches that have gotten away from Thompson here in this inning. The 2-1. Three balls and a strike.
A little bit out of sync just in these last two batters.
See Thompson trying to compose himself out there. Inside corner fastball, three balls and two strikes. With two outs, Garland will be moving with the pitch. Joe Lomnicki bounced out twice to the third baseman in this game. Checks it up. Did he go? No. Back-to-back walks. But runners at first and second will bring up Dan Lodolce.
3-2. Ball above his hands. Able to hold up was Joe Lomnicki. And Walther with another runner in scoring position. Now their fifth opportunity to drive in a run with a runner in scoring position.
Here's a huge at-bat in this game right here. Dan Lodolce. Good hitter in his own right. But should he get on, that brings up Chris Stevens.
Yeah, looming is Stevens, who can hit a gap and put some runs on the board with one swing of the bat.
Lodolce goes after, takes a good cut, and fouls it away.
Lodolce, what a nice game he had yesterday on the mound. Also an outstanding hitter. 3-for-4 yesterday. Also an outstanding center fielder.
0-2. Teutopolis fans making a lot of noise. And that will move runners up to second and third.
Definitely a situation there where Derek Thompson, as much savvy as he has and experience he has, got to stay within himself. He really tried to overpower that ball. Rushed his front side, his arm didn't catch up, and the ball just sailed on him.
One of those game-changing at-bats right here with 1-2 and two outs. In the bottom of the fifth inning, Walther Lutheran at the plate, down by three. He went. Thompson strikes out the side, making the pitch when he had to right there. He strands runners at second and third. Two walks in the inning for Thompson. But the strikeout pitch was working for him. Here in the fifth. One strikeout, two strikeouts, and three. We'll go to the sixth. 3-0, Teutopolis. Lights here at O'Brien Field in downtown Peoria. They had them on at the beginning of the game. We had about a 45-minute weather delay. When we came back, Teutopolis picked up three runs in the top of the fourth inning, and that's been enough so far. Each team with four hits, and we start the sixth with Mark Niebrugge for the Wooden Shoes. And he'll rope the first pitch he sees into left field.
Well, you get the big strikeout to end the inning, and then you get a base hit to lead off your turn at bat, and all of a sudden, Wooden Shoes fans feeling it. Only six outs needed to record a back-to-back state title. We got a pinch runner coming in.
Niebrugge has had some knee problems, and he'll come off. He'll get a big hand from his hometown crowd. Brandon Pals to run over at first base. Now Dylan Hardick, he had a big, big double that drove in a run in the fourth inning. In fact, he drove in the first run of this game. Two for two tonight.
Two big hits in this game. It was Hardick's first RBI of the game, drove in the first run, and then a two-out RBI by Damon Haney that has this 3-1-3-0 margin up on the board.
Short lead at first for Pals. Hardick to third. Barajas, high toss to second. Garland's relay, not in time. Boy, Garland nearly was able to pull that one off. But it was the first throw that disrupted that double play opportunity.
Anthony Garland takes a high throw from Barajas, leaps and gets his left foot on the base and still gets a pretty good turn. Nice play by the defensive gem of a second baseman, Anthony Garland.
We'll bring up Brock Swingler. One out, that runner at first. Very experienced team here for Teutopolis. Six starters returning from last year's state championship game. Thompson, Repking, Blevernick, Overbeck, Hardick, and Niebrugge. Fouled away for Swingler.
The whole top of that batting order has been around for an awful lot of wins in some key, key games, including two state championship appearances.
Swingler, line drive, Garland can't get it. Quickly up is John Lamicki because he saw the runner at first, Hardick, having to hold up in case Garland caught that ball, but it's the sixth hit of the game for Teton. They have runners first and second, one out.
Breaking ball, he went right with it. Diving opportunity by Garland, couldn't come up with it. Lamicki, you see him charging hard. Good presence of mind to throw behind the runner, trying to maybe get the force, if not to get a turn.
Jordan Repke, a fly out and a ground out tonight. Second baseman for Teutopolis, the number eight hitter. Looks to the first pitch from Cockrell. Teutopolis fans playing umpire on every pitch didn't like that call by our home plate umpire, Kirk Hacker.
Ball might have been off the edge. Call goes to the pitcher.
One ball, one strike, one out. And two.
And if you get it once, you're going to get it the second time. No doubt about that. So good job by Cockrell doing that. And a good job by the umpire with his consistency.
That's right.
You've established your strike zone.
One ball, two strikes on Repke. Backing out of play. That's a tough deflection there to make a catch on. Give the guy a break, folks.
Yeah, okay. He's explaining it.
There you go. Yeah, one of the volunteers here to help out with the tournament. And again, Cockrell taking a little bit too long for Repke's preferences. Repke's gone up on the bat a couple of inches here with two strikes on him. And that's three, and he knew it. Good pitch there by Cockrell. He just froze Repke, picks up his third strikeout of the night. That will leave it up to Damon Haney, the clutch two-run double. in the fourth inning. Good pitch from Cockrell.
Haney, arguably the biggest hit of the game. It wasn't the first runs, but it was a separating two runs with two outs.
He's going to get another one. Base hit to right field. Lomnicki will come up throwing. Here it is. The play at the plate. Not in time. Haney with another RBI.
Mr. Clutch, no doubt about it. Damon Haney, third RBI of the night, and all three of them with two outs.
A 4-0 Teutopolis lead.
Short to the ball. Charging hard was the ever-present John Lomnicki, who throws a strike, but with two outs going on the sound of the bat, no play at home plate for the pinch runner pals for Niebrugge.
Now Derek Thompson comes up 0-for-3 tonight. Three runs in the fourth, another here in the sixth. You get the sense here that Thompson's just about ready to unload on one, looking for his first hit of the tournament. Instead, a tapper to first. Miller, whoo, fought that one off. Third out of the inning, but Teutopolis adds another on. The RBI single by Damon Haney. With two outs, we'll give Teutopolis the 4-0 lead as they will head back onto the field. Walther Lutheran needs to get something going. We go to the bottom of the sixth. Going to happen for the Broncos. This would be the stage. 3, 4, and 5. Stevens, Galvin, and Cockrell to face Derek Thompson, who has given up four hits tonight. He's walked a couple of batters. He has struck out four.
Tough a bet for Stevens. He's in a slump. He's retired his last at bat. First time in the entire tournament for the good-looking junior.
Thompson working on a string of three strikeouts in a row. Right off the fists and foul. Ball and two strikes. Two and two.
He's gone borderline probably three different plate appearances in this tournament, gotten a call every time. That's the kind of respect that he has and the kind of eyeballs he has.
This ball is hit high and deep to right center field. This ball is carrying out there, hits at the base of the wall. Stevens with a leadoff double here in the bottom of the sixth.
If you want somebody to be the catalyst, why not, Stevens? That ball hit right at the base of the fence, almost off Greg Maddox's uniform jersey. And he not only gets base hits, but he gets extra base hits, extra base hits, extra base hits.
Josh Galvin up next. A triple and a double tonight for Stevens. Galvin 0-for-2. Bit inside. Jam shot. On one hop to Hardick. Bolivernick comes down with it for the first out.
Bolivernick, a nice big target to work for over there at first base.
6 feet 4 inches tall.
Helps out his feelers quite a bit with that height.
Jack Cockrell, he has a couple of hits here tonight. Last one, a double down the left field line. A lot of Teutopolis fans behind home plate getting a bird's eye view. These offerings from Thompson. Stevens the lead from second. Flashed a little sign to Cockrell there as pitches on the inside corner for a strike.
If you could throw strike one 65 to 70% of the time as a pitcher, that is a legitimate goal. There's no doubt about it. Thompson's probably 75% of the time. He's 0-1 on a hitter.
It's a foul ball right off the foot. The big junior. Trying to work out the bees that are down there. They hit it off higher up. Conversation between catcher and pitcher while Cockrell gets himself readjusted into the batter's box.
So they did two things there. One, they talked about changing their signs with a man on second since they had a free opportunity to do so. But they actually discussed right there what pitch they wanted to throw here. They had a chance to share each other's ideas.
And evidently that clipped the front of the jersey of Cockrell. Kirk Hacker making the call, and it sends a runner down to first base.
They try to do is come on the inner part, and with 0-2, Walther Lutheran definitely catches a break there because you were definitely in the hole against Derek Thompson at 0-2.
Once again, they will send a courtesy runner out. The exchange of helmets, it will go back out to Mike Trotty once again. To the plate comes John Lomnicki. Sacrifice bunt and a ground out tonight against Thompson. We have one out here in the bottom of the sixth inning. That 4-0 Teutopolis lead. Walther Lutheran, you see them on the top step of their dugout. Stevens at second, Trotty at first. Tying run is still in the on-deck circle for Walther Lutheran. Another first pitch strike.
I certainly like the approach by Lomnicki, though. He's anticipating first pitch strike. He's anticipating first ball, fastball. Got it. Took a good hack at it. Very aggressive approach to hitting by a very aggressive baseball player.
Pitches down for a 1-1 count.
Broncos 0-5, runners in scoring position on the evening with another opportunity here.
Snake Eyes on the board. Number 11 at bat. One ball, one strike, one out. Inside, asking whether he went. He did not. Two balls, one strike, one out. To the left side, will it squirt through? Stopped by the shortstop, Hardick. He has no play. The bases are loaded, and the tying run comes to the plate.
Couple opportunities here for some excitement. Justin Fleener jogs out. And just his pace of getting out there is one of a positive pace. It's going out, we're okay. Understand we're up by 4 runs right now, one out at a time. Most certainly the Wooden Shoes will concede any kind of run at all, any 2 runs for 2 outs, believe me.
It's interesting you talk about the pace at which he came out onto the field. So often that does absolutely convey the message.
Yeah, there's no doubt if you walk out in a slow, methodical fashion, it's almost like, okay, we got a problem here. Instead of jogging out, we're fine, we're fine. It's a whole different approach, the way the coach goes out to the mound and the kind of demeanor that he wants to have when he reaches his team and tries to put some positive thoughts into their minds when they have doubt for the first time at all tonight, right now.
Luke Barajas at the plate. He's a 5'9", 170-pound sophomore, .375 batting average. He has just one extra base hit out of his 12 hits this season. Looks at ball one.
Now Luke Barajas, right now as a sophomore, becomes the key hitter in this game for Walther Lutheran.
This one is fouled into the luxury suites. One thing this inning is doing right now with one out is it's starting to turn the order over as you look ahead into the seventh. Barajas, the number seven hitter in the lineup. Can't pull the trigger on that one. Barajas has struck out twice already tonight. Stays alive.
Wasted a pretty good pitch right there by Derek Thompson. Close enough that he had to make a pass to the baseball to stay alive, but it was not a pitch that he could do anything else with but just that.
Called strike three. Two gone in the inning. Sam Cattell to come to the plate. Sixth strikeout of the night. Or Thompson, Cattell a strikeout victim in the fifth inning. Strike one. Thompson ready in a hurry. Strike two.
He's pumping him right now.
Cattell at the plate in a tough spot. One ball, two strikes. Stevens is at third. Trotty at second. Lomnicki at first. A 1-2 to center field. Haney has a beat on it. And that will close the inning. Walther Lutheran loads the bases with one out, but Derek Thompson goes strikeout, fly out. His team is in the dugout. They will come to bat in the seventh inning with a four-run lead in your 2A championship. Teutopolis won a state championship last year in Joliet in Class 2A. They want to duplicate the feat here this year in Peoria, and they've come down to the final inning. Leading 4-0. Dave Bernhardt along with Mark Lindo with you in Peoria. We'll be right back in these seats. However, it'll be a couple hours to the northeast in Joliet next week when 3A and 4A action starts. We'll be with you beginning at 10 o'clock on Friday morning for 3A baseball. We start the top of the seventh inning. Derek Repking to lead it off, number two hitter in the lineup, followed by Blevernick and Overbeck.
What a privilege we have, an opportunity to watch 16 state tournament games and bring those to the people throughout the world on the web.
Garland to Miller, out number one. You know, we talk about the great job that Thompson's done. In fact, he's stranded five runners the last two innings. But how about the job Shaq Cockrell has done here for Walther Lutheran? Limited pitching time here this season. And it's just a three-run fourth inning and one in the sixth. And other than that, very solid performance from the righty.
No doubt about it. One key error by his defense really led to that three-run inning. Double play ball, a play that could have been made, was not. Give the Wooden Shoes credit for taking advantage of it, but that was not the fault of Cockrell at that point. He needed to induce a ground ball. He did. Walther was not able to make the play, and
eventually led to an RBI double by Dylan Hardick, and then a two-out, two-run double by Damon Haney.
Exactly.
Haney adding another RBI, two-out RBI in the sixth inning. Blevernick at the plate for Teutopolis. He's called out on strikes. The ball squirts away from the catcher, and that is strike three. Fourth strikeout of the night.
It's like a straight change right here, or a breaking ball that just spun. How Galvin had trouble with that, he might have been crossed up in some way. But Blevernick never did make an attempt to get to first base.
Garrett Overbeck, a single and a run scored tonight. Center fielder Dan Ladolzi playing very shallow for Overbeck, who has shown power and strength not only in this tournament, but for the entire season. Not much wind right now. Probably the least amount of wind that we have had this entire weekend.
Hey, now one, come on, one.
A lot of dark clouds north of here, though.
Three balls and a strike. Looking ahead to the bottom of the seventh inning, it will be 9-1-2 for Walther Lutheran. Garland, Lomnicki, Ladolci. Down in the dirt, the two-out walk. Now we'll bring Mark Niebrugge. He has a hit and three at-bats tonight. Also scored a run.
I'm sure they'll use a pinch runner for Overbeck here. Or did they use one for him earlier?
They did not.
A pinch hitter steps in, though, however.
That's Niebrugge. Niebrugge technically re-entering the game because he was run four
there
back in the sixth.
So good job by Justin Fleeter to make sure he gets him back in the game officially on the re-entry rule, high school baseball.
You know, and some coaches at the end of the inning that he was run for would tell the umpire, let's re-enter him. But you can wait. You would just wait till your next time around. You never know what the game situation may dictate. Short lead for Overbeck at first. Grell now 2-0 after having walked Overbeck. Soft one. Barajas digs it out of his glove and makes the play across to first. It was pretty simple right now. Teutopolis needs three outs to win their second state baseball championship in school history, their second in a row. Walther Lutheran needs at least four runs to keep this one going. We head to the bottom of the seventh in your 2A championship. In Peoria, it's 4-0 Teutopolis. What were you pointing out?
I just said they were all on their feet.
Oh, okay.
At once, yeah.
Wow. That's a heck of a job. Yeah. Yep.
He threw 90 through 7?
Yeah. One earned run. No, the Walther Lutheran pitcher.
Walther pitcher only threw 90 pitches through 7 innings.
Who's number one? That is Shaq Cockrell. He came off the field after the seventh inning. What a great night for that young man.
Complete game, 7 innings at this point. Only 90 pitches. Very expedient in his delivery, very efficient in his delivery. But he needs help from his teammates now. They got to get at least 4. Or it will go as a state championship loss and a very fine performance. Only 1 earned run against Shaq Cockrell.
Anthony Garland at the plate. 0-2.
Teutopolis fans are going to be cheering every pitch the rest of the way.
Strikeout number 7 is out number 1 in the seventh inning.
And that was his 107th pitch for Derek Thompson. 0-2, right down Broadway. Garland wasn't happy with it, but that was an easy call for the home plate umpire as that split the middle of the plate.
Brings up Joe Lomnicki. Lomnicki 0 for 2 tonight with a walk. Just pouring through the strike zone. 6 hits allowed tonight by Thompson. Look out, he has scattered them, giving up a single hit in the first, second, third, fourth, and then 2 in the sixth. Walked a couple of batters in the fifth inning. He will be slowed up just a bit here.
Yeah.
Lomnicki on the move. Repking to Blevernick.
Somehow you get the feeling that Repking has done that quite often, blocked balls and had to deliver a strike to first base on drop third strikes. Wouldn't shoot fans on their feet in anticipation.
They won a state championship 1 year ago in baseball. Their basketball teams came up short in the super sectionals. As Derek Thompson win the last two championship games played in Class 2A. One strike on LaDolce. Now one pitch away. Ready to spring out of that Teutopolis dugout. Teutopolis, back-to-back titles. Justin Fleener said he felt no pressure to win consecutive state championships. He didn't even know whether his players felt that way or not. They just played ball, and they played it well. Their 33rd victory of the season results in a Class 2A championship.
A dominating season, a dominating performance tonight by Derek Thompson, some timely hitting, and stellar defense, all signs of a championship team. Teutopolis wooden shoes, back-to-back, have done just that. Very few teams in IHSA Lawrence have won back-to-back state titles. Put the wooden shoes on the board as one of them now.
Give credit to Walther Lutheran. Their storybook postseason run comes to an end with an 18-15 record. They were 12-14 entering tournament play. They ran off a string of upsets, extra inning wins. They didn't have one more upset left in them here tonight in Peoria.
What a great run, a great run that other ball clubs can talk about. Hey, remember what Walther Lutheran did entering a regional? Coaches around the area will use that. Handshakes right across home plate. Two teams that represented their school communities with outstanding student athletes shaking hands in the middle of O'Brien Field in Peoria, Illinois.
Congratulations to our two state champions that we crowned here in Peoria this weekend. Carrollton earlier today, an 8-1 winner over Eastland High School. And here in this one, a shutout. Derek Thompson gets it. Teutopolis 4, Walther Lutheran nothing. Now remember, next week we come to you from Joliet. Silver Cross Field, the home of the Joliet Slammers. It will be 3A and 4A baseball. We'll get things rolling. Eight games beginning at 10 o'clock next Friday morning. Glad you joined us here from Peoria. Of course, you can get all your DVD copies of these tournament games at prepfilms.com, your online store for IHSA tournament films. Congratulations once again to Teutopolis, your 2A state baseball champions, 4-0 over Walther Lutheran. For Mark Lindo, I'm Dave Bernhard. Our thanks go out to you for joining us and our entire When We Were Young Productions crew. We will talk to you in 1 week from Joliet. Good night, everybody.
Thank you.